Hachette Audio presents Humblebrag, The Art of False Modesty. Written and read by Harris Wittels.
Dedicated to Mom, Dad, Steph, Ganny, and Scarlett Johansson. Author's note. If you were included in this book, while I can see how you would think I'm a dick, I hope that you know it's all in good fun. Everyone humble brags. I do it too. A lot. Thanks for being a chiller. Introduction. Man, I can't believe this dumb little word I came up with actually got me a book deal. Did that last sentence annoy you? It should have. But can you not quite put your finger on why it annoyed you? Well, it's because that type of statement is what I like to call a humble brag, and it's what this book is all about. First, let's define a humble brag. Humble brag, noun, verb. A specific type of brag that masks the boasting part of a statement in a faux humble guise. The false humility allows the offender to boast about their achievements without any sense of shame or guilt. Humble brags are usually self-deprecating in nature, but there are a few exceptions, which are mentioned later in this book. Here is an example of a standard humble brag, which was tweeted by late-night talk show host Craig Ferguson, aka @CraigieFerg. I just got nominated for a damn Grammy. Take that, low self-esteem. #fuckyeah. The brag element of this tweet is that he was nominated for a Grammy, whereas the humble element is his low self-esteem. Here is another example from some fellow named Sam Halliday from some band called Two Door Cinema Club. Our song has just come on the radio in our taxi. Awkward. In this tweet, he's bragging about his band's song being played on the radio, while disguising it as an awkward situation that he was forced to endure. Incidentally, the use of the words awkward or weird are quite commonly used in humble brags. In fact, there's a whole section of the book devoted to it. Don't skip to it, just take my word for it for now. Hopefully you're getting the hang of it now. It's not difficult. This book is basically a collection of my favorite humble brags I found on Twitter and elsewhere. Also, there are some jokes about said humble brags, and then also some other stuff. I hope you enjoy it. It was really a pain in the ass to write. See? That was another humble brag. I didn't really notice humble brags until I moved to Los Angeles in 2006. I love living here, but man, going to a party out here is a nonstop humble brag fest. People complaining about how their pilots probably won't get picked up or how a studio gave their screenplay some shitty notes. It can truly be endless. It's just kind of how people communicate out here. I'm generalizing, of course. Not everyone in LA does that. Also, it isn't just in LA that people are shamelessly self-promotional and aggrandizing. I'm sure that right now, somewhere in Brooklyn, a street artist is saying he put a picture of Mao Zedong on the highest Nike billboard, but it sucks that he got arrested. Or that in Ireland, someone is saying he grew the biggest potato. But aye, was it hard work. It happens everywhere, all the time, but I just noticed it in LA specifically. Yet for a while, I couldn't name exactly what I was noticing. I just knew it wasn't straight up bragging. Then Twitter blew up and I started constantly seeing these kinds of statements typed out for the world to see. This was the perfect medium for it, and I finally identified what it was and why it annoyed me. It was bragging, but it wasn't just bragging. It was a type of bragging that included some amount of fake modesty, which somehow made it acceptable to do. Every time I would read one, I would think, why would that person say that? What's the point? It can only serve to make people jealous of you and/or hate you. No one ever hears one and actually thinks you're cooler, but people do it because it's in their nature to prove to others how great their life is. Or maybe they're actually just trying to prove it to themselves? Shit's deep, yo. I fought the impulse many times to respond to all of these offenders on Twitter with, why did you feel the need to tell the world that? But I was scared to burn bridges. Instead, I just silently stewed in my resentment for a couple years. Then I became too fed up with seeing people repeatedly doing it, so I once tweeted, guys, if you're going to brag, don't be humble about it. Just brag. And from that, I coined the phrase humblebrag and started up an anonymous Twitter account, twitter.com/humblebrag, where I would retweet any flagrant humblebraggers. The first humblebrag I ever retweeted was by Donald Glover, an actor on NBC's Community and rapper Childish Gambino. He, at Mr. Donald Glover, tweeted, "It's an honor to be the first thing Japanese men see after reading their porn on the subway." Then, there was an attached photo of a Gap ad featuring a photo of himself. Clearly, he just wanted to let us all know he was in a Gap ad. That's where it all began. Childish Gambino has since name-checked humblebrag in one of his songs, making this whole thing worth it. Wait, was this a humblebrag? Probably. Then I retweeted a few more from a few different people, and a few more after that, and so on. Soon after that, the Twitter account's follower count started to grow exponentially and people began emailing humblebrag@gmail.com with suggestions for people I could retweet. Friends of theirs, bosses, celebrities they followed. And what started as an inside joke between me and the writing staff at Parks and Recreation, where I work, became somewhat of a second job for me, where I would sift through hundreds of emails a week, searching for leads on any humblebrags. It is most definitely a gigantic waste of time, but I like to think I'm doing some sort of service for society, #humblebrag, putting humblebraggers in check so that we can get back to a time when braggers either outright bragged like assholes or just didn't do it at all. Ugh, I know famous people. Let's start off with one of the most commonly used forms of humblebragging, which is the name drop humblebrag. No one likes a name dropper. Add to that some phony self-deprecation and you have a not fun thing. There are a couple kinds of these. One kind is committed by normal people and the other by celebrities. What's funny about normal people saying things like, "I totally drank too much while hanging out with Johnny Depp," is that hanging out usually means they were at the same bar and drunkenly yelled at Johnny Depp that they went to the same high school. I bet Johnny Depp didn't consider it a hang. What's funny about when a celebrity does it is that it's usually an attempt to show that they're a normal person. They aren't, though, is the thing. Noah Harlan, @Noah Harlan. In other news, Paul McCartney stole our golf cart. I'm serious. #honored or pissed. Paul McCartney, the Beatle, right? So, honored probably? Final answer. Damon Lindelof, @Damon Lindelof. Sitting next to Penny Marshall at the Lakers game, #geeking out. There is a chance he actually was geeking out there, but he's the creator of Lost. He's been around famous people before. I have a slight bugaboo about celebrities trying to show that they are still normal and on our level by getting nervous around other celebrities. Josh Horowitz, @Joshua Horowitz. Dan Radcliffe just showed me a text he just got from J.K. Rowling, which just about blew my mind. Can't say what it said. Sorry. Well, so why tell us this then, you know? Also, I thought his name was Daniel, but I guess if you're close friends, it's just Dan or something. Kelly Bourdais, @Kelly Bourdais. Just spent 30 minutes on the phone with Johnny Knoxville talking about period sex. Okay. Machine Gun Kelly, @Machine Gun Kelly. You ever been called on stage by DMX in front of 20,000 people to perform a song and forgot the lyrics because you were so nervous? I have, LOL. I'm going to go ahead and assume this was a rhetorical question. He couldn't have possibly wondered if anyone besides himself has forgotten DMX lyrics after being called up on stage, right? It's such a specific and narrow margin of people who have experienced that. That being said, if I were him, I would have been more nervous to tweet this than I would have to get on stage with DMX, namely because DMX hasn't been relevant in like 8 years and this tweet was annoying, especially with the LOL edition. Also, his Twitter bio starts with, "I like threesomes." Come on, dude, let's try a little harder to not be a parody of a musician. Wiz Khalifa, @RealWizKhalifa. I'm very thankful that the Isley brothers are letting me smoke with them right now. That's beautiful, man. Acting Keith, @ActingKeith. OMG, getting two drunk movie stars home to sleep is much rougher than getting one drunk movie star home to sleep. Hashtag responsible. The only way this isn't a humble brag is if acting Keith is a cab driver. Then it's just part of the job.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.